In addition to the American holly, I've added the crocus to the snow garden. No wonder, because it does seem to pop up even if there's snow on the ground. And one of the reasons is because its stem grows below ground, and so it's somewhat protected. It also, the petals close up at night or when there's bad weather. So it's a six-petal flower. So you've got the two pieces here to do that. It comes in colors from yellow to orange to varying shades of purple, from light to dark. I'm gonna do a yellow one. And so I'm mixing a couple of colors from Olo. This is Y2.3, which is very bright yellow. But I want a kind of a rich yellow, so I'm going to add the Y2.3 on top of it. So I'm gonna turn it around on the underside here and also do this one. I'm just brushing from the outside in, kind of leaving a little bit of white on the inside of the petals there. And you'll notice I've actually kind of pulled this petal out a bit as far as the length goes, and I'll explain why, because these have, they're almost like a, let's say a trumpet, you know, where it's got that narrow part. And so to create that, I added this extra length in the center so you can form them in your molding tray and get them exactly right. So I'm just doing the top. I'm gonna leave the inside the brighter yellow. I'm adding that Y02.3. which is called butterscotch. And it just kind of tones it down, gives it a little richer color. Now, as I set that aside, while I'm coloring, I might as well do its little stamen. Like I said, these are these little like filaments, they're called carpels. And the center one that contains the saffron that they harvest is called the stigma. But they're so tiny, you can see why, you know, like here I've got a bottle of saffron, and this is probably about $30 worth of saffron that actually my daughter brought it back from Turkey when she was there, so on a conference. You don't need to cut these. Let me set that aside just a second. You also have these very fine leaves. And so I'm just gonna color them. This is YG8.5. I'm not going to add any kind of particular shading. They're, you know, pretty fine. So you don't have a lot of thickness there to really work with. But I'll show you how I'm going to get these to shape a bit. But we'll get all our coloring done, and then we'll move on to shaping the flowers. As you can see, this die set also contains another little ladybug. And so if you're getting your collection, I have quite a few from all the collections I've done. So I cut them, you know, lay them out on the paper and cut them all at once. And then I fill little jars full of ladybugs, so when I want to add them to my flowers. So that's a good trick. So grab your tool in one, and I've put in the medium ball stylus and the small loop tool. On with the petals facing on the right side down, so you've got wrong side up, first go ahead and just soften around the edges with your medium ball stylus. I'm going to do this to all six petals. You want that kind of cupping in. Now I'm going to switch to my loop tool and just kind of gently stroke it in. You don't have to press too hard now because you've softened the paper a bit. I'm using my specialty cardstock. It colors beautifully and shapes really nicely. Plus gives you a natural looking petal with the little bit of texture it has with it. So I'm just shaping. And now I'm gonna grab my tweezers and pinch right where it would connect to the stem. I'm gonna do this one as well. There we go. And then I'm gonna use the very small ball stylus. So you can either switch it out. Remember, when you're putting your tools in, there is a little like ball bearing there. You wanna match it up with the notches, but you wanna put your tools all the way down. Don't have any of the notches showing. You want them all the way down. That gives you the most stability of your tools. So I'm gonna just cup in the center. And then we're going to glue those two pieces together. So adding a little bit of glue. I'm going to hold this one. I'm going to kind of find, these are my other petals, so I'm going to turn it around. Whoops, turn it around this way. You can see these are tiny little guys. And I want to put, wait, I want to grab this one, I think. Yep. And I'm gonna offset them. So you've got them right in between, and I'll bring it kind of up a bit. But this is what I'm talking about with your molding tray. So using the very, whoops, turn it over, smallest size, the 1/4 inch, I want you to put it and then take your small ball stylus and just gently coax it down into the opening. We're gonna let that one dry a bit while we do our stamen and our leaves. So I'm gonna need my leaf pad and leaf tool next. So like I said, on the leaves, there's not a lot of room to really, there's no veining on it, but I am going to draw a line using my leaf tool. I'm gonna draw a line going right down from the edge of the petal downward. You don't want to pull away because you could pull these apart. They're very fine little needle-like leaves that are on. And this one wants to not stay over there. Same thing with the little one here. I've got two different sizes and you can cut as many as you want. It's usually a cluster around the flower. So, and then to add, it's too tiny to use my pan pastel, so I'm just using a fine line pen and just going over that line a bit so you get a little bit of shading. But you can see by coloring with the alcohol ink, you know, where I started here, I got a little darker here, got a little darker out there. Wherever you go over it several times, you know, you'll get some shading naturally, but I want to really accentuate that stem line coming down. And then all you have to do is kind of pinch these together so they sit up a bit. Next, we're going to do our stamen. So I've colored it in that orange color because of the color of the saffron, and I use 0.2.4. So I don't know if you can see that or not. You don't need to cut these apart. I want them kind of thicker. That's what holds the saffron, especially with the stigma one on the middle. Kind of like the main carpel. And I'm gonna roll that up. I grabbed a hold of that little tail, roll it up. And I'm gonna turn it a couple times in my hand, pull it off my, I think I'm gonna pull it off my tweezers there. And just gently open these up. Now you can take your glue and just add a little bit onto these. And I'm using the orange pollen. to match. You know, as it dries, as the saffron dries, it darkens, but it is orange when it's freshly picked or harvested. So where's my other, my other tweezers? Here they are. I'm gonna hold the stamen by the top. I'm gonna pull this out a bit and just open up a little bit. But you can see I've created that little tube-like area, like a trumpet, with the formation in the, I'll just dip that in glue and put that in there, there. So that's your finished flower. One is very easy to do. I've got a quick little project here. Did my Victorian teacup, and I did it in a spackle kind of, or speckleware. And let's put another little group of one here. And so see, you've got the a little cluster as if they grow, and then I can add my leaves. I'll just dip this in and add a long stem there and maybe a shorter one on the other side. These crocus are just so sweet. They'll go, it's a nice size, will go with a number of flowers. I've added it here with the narcissus, but, and picking up the yellows and that orange just to blend, and then that pop of blue. So one more thing and then we'll be all done. So of course, this has got to have a little ladybug. She's probably still hibernating if the weather is snowy, but she does like to protect. So I've colored her with R1.5 in the Olo, and then I'm gonna just use a Uniball pen in black to color her hair, head, and then divide her wings and add her little spots. You want to use your small ball stylus to cup her, give her some form, make her look nice and round and chubby here. And then let me grab a little bit of glue. Make sure underneath is covered here. And then I'm gonna try to put her, right in here. She's crawling up to cuddle inside and get close there. Now I'm using Kids' Choice glue, so it will dry perfectly clear.